never thought I would be at 23 on the verge of spontaneous combustion. Woe is me, but I guess that it comes with a territory, an ominous landscape of never-ending calamity. I need you to hear, I need you to see, but I am an, or I can take an exploding scene, like an infinite possibility. I was having a look in a book, and I saw a picture of a guy right up above his knee. I said, I can relate, cause lately I've been thinking of combusted kitchen as a welcome vacation from the burdens of the planet Earth, like gravity, hypocrisy, and the perils of being in free. But thinking so much different.
Okay, Mike, what do you think about David Ellis and his techniques?
I think his techniques are different than most artists. I really like him, the way he designs things, the way he thinks of stuff in his head.
Okay. Describe your feelings on the process in which David brought to us.
I like it a lot. It's different than most artists. It's funner. You gotta work a lot faster. Sometimes if you slow it down, you can work a little bit slower, but I like the aspect of it. Different takes, pictures, the people in the pictures, and just how they can work a little bit, how to work fast.
Would you like to have more opportunities like this to work with other artists?
Yeah, I think it's a good learning experience. It taught me a lot of stuff on how to just do it, don't think about it, just go for what's in your head, just put it on paper.
Okay, thanks. All right, guys, here we go. Hey, what do you think of David Ellis and his techniques that he brought to JM?
It was really different, to work with, interact with people and what he's doing and showing us, because we not only just did the painting part of it, but we used objects,
too.
It's
more fun and creative than just drawing or painting something on a piece of paper.
It's more like motion, action.
Yeah,
it's art in action. Describe your feelings on the process that David brought to Jefferson Morgan. Like the process, like from step by step, what did you have to do? I mean, you had to make...
You have to like think, because you have to show what you would do in that motion and put it into something else.
It's a little bit slower, but it's still fun.
Did you use anything other than just art techniques? Did you have technology involved?
Cameras, laptops.
Okay.
Music.
Would you like to have more opportunities like this to work with other artists? If the Mattress Factory would bring them in and we could apply for grants?
Definitely, because it's opening our
it's more
art experience.
Creative.
Okay, thank you, girls. Okay, guys. Hey, what do you think of David Ellis and his techniques that he brought to Jefferson Morgan?
I think the techniques are great. And how we get to work with all the different technology and stuff, I think it's really cool.
It's a lot more intense than what we do every day.
Yeah, definitely. Describe your feelings on the process from step by step and how things worked during the technique he brought.
I think you have to work at a faster pace, and you have to think a lot, more thoroughly.
Did you enjoy the outcome of what happened and we produced here at JM?
Yeah.
Okay, would you like to have more opportunities like this with other artists coming into the school and demonstrating
awesome.
Their different techniques?
It helps everybody experience art and get a better understanding of different artists and different art techniques.
Okay, thank you.
I want to take this opportunity to thank the Mattress Factory for allowing and finding David Ellis for us and letting him come to the art room at Jefferson Morgan and show my students different forms of art and a different way of producing art. We dealt with a great project in installation art with his time-lapse photography, and the 4 days he was here, we compressed it into a 5 to 6 minute video.
Hello, Dave. How was your stay at Jefferson Morgan?
It was great. Jefferson Morgan is real similar to the size of school that I went to for high school in North Carolina. And it's kind of almost giving me flashbacks being here. It's taking me back like 20 years. And I've gotten a lot from being here, Like, it's good to be around young people, sort of see what young people are thinking, and see that, that there is something coming up behind my generation. And I feel good to sort of share what I've learned. And hopefully one of these cats will run with the ball, and take everything a lot further. That's what I hope.
What did you think of the enthusiasm of the students?
Over the top. Over the top.
That's great. What were your feelings of the whole project and the process at hand?
Well, I got off a plane, like a 30-hour flight from New Zealand. So the first day I was jet lagged, and you were graceful enough to let me bail on the first day and get my head together, but we basically rolled in here, you and I, with three emails between us and not a whole big plan, so it was great to sort of build with you that first day and brainstorm about what we might do. And I'm an improviser, and I get the sense that you are too, in the way you do your class, whatever group comes in, you're able to sort of flex and adjust to that time of day. And so that's why we get along. And then, so between the two of us, I think we're able to go with the flow. And that's really what I've tried to keep essential in my work, is to not be like, okay, next week I'm going to do this. It's like, next week, I'll see what I'm going to do.
Okay, Dave, what are your views on, the copywriting of other people's work? And
Yeah. That's a complicated issue, and it usually involves lawyers and contracts. But I think everybody in their gut has an ethical feeling about when you borrow something heavily, and I think we all do it. I think artists would not be able to survive and go further without looking at what other artists did. And that's a big thing for me. It's the same with music. Like, you might hear 10 different groups do the same song, but they're going to do it differently, you know? And, like, I may be using a technique that looks original right now to some people, but to be honest, they were using stop motion on painting in the 30s. You know, it's like, I'm not doing anything new. But I am trying to, like, go in a direction that my development has taken me, and that means I want to make paintings move. I want to make paintings work more like music and travel through time and have rhythm. And so, and I want to be able to improvise in the way musicians can improvise. You may have, like, you may know every chord change there is, and you may know how to do every note with precision. You may have every bit of technique, but if you can't make those notes yours and come up with some sort of groove that comes from within you and your experiences, then you're flat. You might as well just be a computer. But I think, you know, so, like, what we did here is, I branded it in a way because it's on YouTube and people right. see that. But you shouldn't be afraid to use this technique and find your own path with it. You know, right. this is just a tech. That's like saying, like, somebody with the first guy with a brush and a can of paint, nobody else can paint because he did that first. It's like, this is just one way to sort of break the mold and, like, find some new directions. And hopefully this could develop into something else. As technology becomes more accessible and the programs become easier to use, which they're at the peak right now, we can run with it.
Well, Dave, we thank you for coming, and we appreciate it, and we hope to see you again. Thanks, Dave.
Peace.
Andrew, can you describe your experience at the Mattress Factory?
I thought it was a great learning experience, and I was very thankful that they could find the artist, David Ellis, for us. To have a hands-on experience with an artist.
Amanda, describe your experience at the Mattress Factory.
It was cool and different, and I'm glad we got to go because it showed that art isn't just painting on a picture. It's, it can be more than that.
Steve, describe your experience at the Mattress Factory.
Mattress Factory was an amazing learning experience. I got to see all kinds of different art I've never seen before. We learned a lot about the art and how the artist made them, their different techniques. It's a lot of really creative things. I like how that they use whole rooms to do their art. It's a wonderful experience that should be given opportunity to more schools, more students.
I really want to take this opportunity to thank the Mattress Factory for, you know, giving us the opportunity to have an artist come into our school and to show us different techniques. I hope a lot of other schools get the opportunity in which we got to have an artist come in. I'm really appreciative for them to consider us and give us that chance.